Nazi about the fact that they saw the final confirmation. But all this is wrong. Amir Khusral poetry itself shows that Kashkula meant a woman, particularly a Turkish woman. And remember that even in Hafiz's verse, Turkey woman, the Turkish woman is the beloved. There is a verse of Amir Khusral himself in Musa, the last verse, where he speaks of the Mahi Kashkula coming on the dam or coming on the roof. As well noted, in 19th century, women could be seen in Bukhara only when they came on the roof. So, the Mahi Kashkula comes on the roof and Amir Khusral, the lover, his voice of exaltation and seeing her reaches the moon. So, she is also moon-like and the noise also reaches the moon. This is the verse. So quite obviously, to Amir Khusra and Amir Hasan Sitsi, Kashkula did not mean a Sufi with an auric hat, it meant a woman with an auric hat. And therefore, this kind of misinterpretation of worldly verses has been continuing in India continuously. In the case of Sufi, actually give another example. Ishq to Hafiz as the next stage in the poetry of dissent and secularism. Now the first point is that Hafiz's beloved is also a woman. I was reading, I don't know how many people of you are familiar with this book. Several classes, concise encyclopedia of Islam. He said in his preface that he is a Sunni Muslim, which I thought is an unnecessary statement. It doesn't matter who writes on Islam. Anyway, he says that. And then when he comes to Hafiz, he says that William Jones was incorrect in translating. It's a beautiful translating of the translation of that ghazal. The Turkish woman to whom, to her, for whose whole novel he was going willing to give away Samarkand and Bukhara. Agara to Kishiraji Badastaras Birimara. Nahali Hindu Ashbaksham Samarkand and Bukhara. And this fellow, instead of Turkish maid, translates Turkish boy and spoils the whole couplet. But what about Hafiz himself? He clearly says that his beloved is always a woman. I'm not a Hafiz expert, but from cursory reading I could get two verses. Mashuqa ayami kardar. Not mashuq, mashuqa ayami kardar. Sarf shud umre garam aya ba mashuqa o main. Not mashuq, mashuq o main.
وقت حافظ گر عظیم گونا مدد خواہد کرو.
He's getting his fate. He says, if my fate continues like that,
زلف معشوقا بدست فکرا
خواہد بھول, then others will be fondling my beloved woman's hair. معشوقا. And جہانگیر says plainly to نظیری, perhaps نظیری has written a couplet where the beloved seemed to be too meaty made. So Jahangir said,
Mulla Naziri Mahshuk Muannasast.
Feminine. This simple truth is missing in all, in much of literary criticism. The woman beloved is the object of the poet's love. And Ur Hafiz makes it clear. Now, the second thing in Hafiz is not only the glorification of human love, worldly love, but the rejection of orthodoxy in terms which have not been seen in previous poets.
The Mahsad Jada Rangi Kun Agar Pire Mukha Goyat Kisalib Be Khabar Nafad Zirahu Rasmi Manzirha. cover the poor carpet with money if your period of abundance. For the traveler should always be, and this he means a spiritual traveler, should always follow the customs of the journey. Mahurida, Rubasure Kaba Chumar Ema, Rubasure Khanare Khumar Tarat Pirima. We are looking at Kaba, but our peer is looking to the wine shop, to the liquor shop. Hafizami for Barandi Kun Bakushbash. Vajay Tadbir Makun Chundigra Quran Ra. Hafiz, eat and be merry and loaf about, but don't play games with the Quran. Or even invoking pantheism, Mansoor, Nakshyan al-Haq par zameen-e-hum. Now, or because of blaming the hypocrisy in the famous verse, Vaidha ki jalwa par mehrabu member mi kunan, kyun bakhil par mi rafanda, kari di garmi kunagi. It is so general that I need not. Now, I think, after writing all this, Hafiz had cold feet. And therefore in one poem he says, all I have said, regard it as verse of for Marifat. You know what? Hafiz today is dismissed as again, a mystic. So he himself says, in one verse, this is all Marifat. But if you apply Marifat, what the result you will receive? If you think that beloved is always God, and I admit that Sufis thought of God as a woman. In Mir Hasan Sidzi's report of conversations of Nizamuddin Aulia, he says that Nizamuddin Aulia said that in pursuing love of God, one has the same difficulties as in human love. After second or third day, after first greeting the lover, the woman begins to spurn her, and then he says that he made a gesture like a woman spurning her lover. So it's true that Sufis, because they emphasize love of God rather than the aspiration to go to heaven, really make use of human parallels. But if you say, well, if when Hafiz says, Shere Hafiz Huma Baitul Badale Marifat As, let us apply this to one verse and what conclusion one would reach, which perhaps I don't know whether Hafiz intended. Hafiz has one verse which I regard as extremely important. عشق نا تمام ما جمال یار مستغنیس بآب و رنگ و خال و خط جہاجت ہوئے دیارا. Its plain meaning is, if I have so much love for the beloved woman, her beauty is enriched by my love. She has no need for those facial beauties. Abo rango khalo khat. Kyun no need? My great love is enough. If you apply the principle of marifat to this verse, what you get? That God is really what I conceive Him to be. Therefore God, it's all in my love. That's the meaning you will get. A very dangerous meaning. If you apply my principle of tasavvuf to this kind of worldly poet. Did Hafiz have that idea? that the whole divine order, God's creation and so on, is created in our own imagination. It has no reality. Did he have that? God doesn't know. If you apply the principle of marifat, this is what he is saying. If you apply it only to worldly love, he gets away with the feeling that your beloved benefits from your eyes of love. The eyes of love see what does not exist here. So I think that the marifat principle, if it has to be applied, should be applied across the board. And perhaps then you will get results from a study of Hafiz which would have perhaps surprised Hafiz himself. There was a continuous denunciation of orthodoxy as riyakari, as riya, hypocrisy and so on, which is full of it. But there is one final word in Hafiz which could be later developed. That there is in this world the possibility of change, which I regard as a very important element that Hafiz introduces here and there, but he does introduce. Can human beings change the world? Now I can go only a couple of verses. Nafs baadi saba mushk peshan wahashud aalame peer digar bara jama pahunchud. There is